Since you were locked in Nimzia, summer has entered into full swing. The evenings are filled with the sounds of nature blooming as the solstice approaches. The closer this ancient holiday gets, the thinner the border between worlds becomes. So it also seems, at this very moment, as you feel the presence of new shorts near the shores of the Kolva. You see a man pensively walking towards the river in the glare of the setting sun. He glances at you with piercing eyes and continues to gaze at the shimmering Kolva in the distance. He seems to be muttering something to himself.
God helps.
Oh, there's no need to be pleasant, witch. I know you. I know a lot of things. But I don't care about that. I, in my cognition, have stained myself with knowledge to such a degree that it is as if I've been living on this earth since the dawn of time, more than 5,000 years. And all this without your chorts. You may have the books, you may have hundreds of chorts. I don't care for that. I am here to contemplate the eternal. And what do I get from talking to you? It's a waste of time. You go and fuss with your chorts. This is your way. But I'm off to enjoy this beautiful summer sunset on the bank of our Kolva. Though it's still cold, it hasn't warmed up yet. Well, be on your way. I must go to the river.
While you think about the man's enigmatic words, he disappears into the warm haze of the sunset. Could it be his speech wasn't really that incoherent? At the crossroads of two trade routes, you see the annual fair. Despite the late hour, trading is still taking place. Perhaps you might buy something for your journey. A multitude of goods can be found. Prianix, as well as a variety of magic trinkets. There's something for everyone here.
Wisdom will enter your heart and be good for your soul.
Buy an amulet and a trinket. Buy a potion and drink it. You'll be as healthy as a boar, demons fleeing from your roar. an amulet and a trinket. Buy a potion, then drink it. You'll be as healthy as a boar, demons fleeing from your roar.
The players are carried away by a game of Durak. You see a Khaldun approaching. He lives in one of the neighboring villages. You scarcely know him. He notices you and comes closer. In his hands, you see a beautiful bag, decorated with striking floral patterns. You have a bad feeling about this.
Is this you, Vasilisa? My, you've grown into such a beauty. Well, look at you. And I didn't recognize you at first. Well, looking good, eh? A girl like you needs a nice bag. A witch needs one so the more, to carry books and such.
The Khaldun gives you his bag.
Here, it won't cost you much.
Oh no. Who knows what's inside the bag? You carry it. I have mine.
Damn you. Never mind. I'll find someone to give it to. So long.
When you approach the old bridge, you realize the demons are waiting for you, clumsily trying to hide among the rotting logs. You've seen these chorts before, on that fateful day of the fight with Alexander. You don't leave anything to chance, and read the first Zagavar.